Maxine Waters was back in Los Angeles over the weekend to launch her 2018 re-election campaign, but the California Congresswoman refused to alert the media. That seems so bizarre, doesn't it? Well, not if you're Whacky Waters returning to what was the scene of an epic defeat and embarrassment. Waters snuck her way into Los Angeles, hoping to fly under the radar. Going totally radio silent on all her social media accounts, it's like she went into hiding as she landed at LAX International Airport. Traveling in her luxury automobile with tinted glass, Waters slipped into her Hancock Park neighborhood undetected, with only her trusted staffers knowing her whereabouts. This sounds pretty creepy unless you're a spy on a mission. Well, we've put together exactly what happened, and you will love this. The last time Mad Maxine attempted to have a town hall in her own district, it was overrun by President Donald Trump supporters. Last June, Mad World News reported, Maxine Waters' town hall turned into a nightmare for the 78-year-old congresswoman. Right from the beginning, it was plain to those who supported Trump that they would not be allowed entrance, so they started chanting "Let us in." Calling her Dirty Waters, the protesters got very incensed as they heard Maxine start rattling on about Trump colluding with Putin. Immediately, they started yelling, "Respect our president," and that drowned out Maxine so badly that she reacted by chanting on her mic, "Impeach 45. When she was unable to stop the protesters and could no longer continue her talk, she lost her cool and started screaming, "Stop the disruption. Stop it. You will not disrupt my town hall." But the real coup de grace by the Trump supporters came when Maxine was trying to leave. Video footage shows a terrified Maxine surrounded by her handlers and police as they discuss her exit. She was scared because the protesters had a real nasty surprise. They surrounded every exit of that community center, waiting to let her know once again that she isn't welcome in her own district. Let's be clear about one thing here. The Trump supporters acted like real patriots. Never did they incite violence. They were exercising their First Amendment rights, and unlike those who Waters praises, such as the liberal rats in Antifa and Black Lives Matter, these Americans were telling the truth. That terrified Maxine Waters. Finally, a small blue door on one side of the building opened and Maxine scurried out to her waiting SUV, surrounded by police. The crowd erupted into booing and a fugue gave her a silent salute of the middle finger as her SUV slowly made its way through the screaming crowd. One African-American man who lives in her district yelled on his bullhorn as she appeared from the building, "Dirty Waters has got to go, Dirty Waters has got to go." Well, that was the last time Maxine attempted a town hall in District 43. This time, she took every precaution to make sure only her cabal of trusted supporters were notified that, on January 13, they were invited to a fake town hall meeting. Everyone had to keep it on the down low that Mad Max was back in town. Look at these people's faces in the photo below. This was just tweeted out by Mad Max, and it is the only picture to come out of her crowd after the pathetic fake town hall. It shows her supporters looking rather glum. This tells me that Maxine is in deep crap if she can't even hold a freaking town hall event in her own district. This has to be a first. A politician holds a campaign event in her home district, and she is so damn scared of her constituents that she has to go into hiding and hold a fake town hall. Well, this is looking good for her GOP challenger, Omar Navarro. Maybe the impoverished area of District 43 in California is ready to kick the poverty pimp, Maxine, to the curb. God knows the good people in California who value America could use someone fighting for them in Washington, D.C.